Edit, wanna make dreams come true?
Yeah!
Let's push the button.
Coming up on today's show. One dreamer joins the crew of the Street Dance Masters. Diversity! Professional jockey Barry Garrity saddles up to make a dream come true. We give One Dreamer a luminous behind-the-scenes access to one of our cool new video shoots. Plus, One Dreamer gets one of my dream jobs as a taste tester at a crisp factory. Awesome!
From Dundrum. She loves to bust some funky, funky moves. She wrote to us saying, I have been doing hip-hop dancing for the last 5 years. My dance hero is Ashley Banjo from Diversity. My dream would be to hit the hip-hop dance floor with him. One dance lesson with Ashley Banjo coming right up. And French fries.
Tiana, you wrote to Dream Factory, asked us to give you a dance workshop with Ashley Banjo at Diversity.
Oh my God, thank you so much. I'm gonna cry to say so much. Thank you so much.
So this morning, really, really early, we got to the airport and we got on a flight over to London. When we arrived, I came to Ashley Banjo's studio. I was nervously waiting by myself and then Ashley Banjo walked in. Hi.
Diaba, how are you?
Good.
Give me a hug. How are you?
Good, good, you're so tall. Oh, braids like me.
Braids, yeah.
The first thing I did was give her a little tour of the studio.
All right, Niama, so this is Diversity.
Oh, wow. So big.
It's cool, right?
Yeah.
And in here, this is prop and costume room.
It's amazing.
You have to recognise this one. This is what we won Britain's Got Talent in.
Yep.
Over here is where we make all our music.
I love your remixes and stuff.
Oh, yes, this is where we make it. You know, like, when you come to see our shows, it kind of says things like, we are Diversity. And
yeah.
It kind of, and you know, like, it says, like, Diversity, the voiceovers.
You do it here?
All here. So, Niama, tell me a little bit about you and dancing.
I've been dancing for 5 years.
5 years?
Yeah.
How often do you dance? How many times a week?
I do it twice, but I do it for hours and hours.
Okay.
And then in my room, I have mirrors, so I just keep, you know, dance.
You have mirrors in your room?
Yeah. Just dance all the time.
When I saw her dance, I was pleasantly surprised.
Roll like that. And once you've done your chest, roll your legs, step back.
Step
so
back.
Check it, ready? That's good, that's really good. You got that pass, that pass, ready?
I'm a dancer and I have a fear of popping. Popping is when you like pop your muscles. I told them that I'm not really that good at it.
What we thought we'd do is show her a little bit of her weakness. Here, here, here. Here, step and look. So, don't worry, don't worry. Ready? Look here. You don't just have to do what you're good at. Do what you're bad at and learn something new every day. Doosh, 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 and sha.
I'm not really into that side of dancing, but I might take it up.
I think we should show the boys.
Can we do that?
Okay.
Yes! I'm gonna get him in.
The most nerve-wracking part was when all of diversity walked in.
All right, Niamh, this is diversity.
Hi. I asked them to show me like some of their flips and some of their breakdancing.
Pell, let's do this combo. Over the head, tail catch.
All right.
Yeah?
Hey!
They showed me one of their routines that they'd done on their tour. When they done the dance all together, I was like shocked because usually I see it on camera, but it was actually right in front of me, so it's good.
Oh, anyway, yeah, we'll show you a little bit.
Yeah, it was amazing.
No worries. Yeah.
Ashley had one last surprise for me.
Let's do it matching. Proper dance crew.
Give it a try.
Here we go. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8.
It's really difficult for Niamh what she did today. She was standing up front and centre of a professional, experienced dance group. She held her own. That shows so much potential.
6, 6. Niamh, I'm very proud. You looked very good. You were part of the crew. And it's really nice to have met you.
Thank you.
So thank you very much for coming down.
Thank you.
No worries.
Thanks, Edward, for making my dream come true. Peace out.
You like really like diversity, Kay. When was the first time you saw diversity on Britain's Got Talent?
Yeah.
And what do you think was so special about them?
They're just really good dancers.
How did it feel dancing with them?
It's amazing.
Learned some pretty cool dance moves. Do you want to show some dance moves now?
Yeah.
Let's go for it. Do it! And Niamh, you're our dance teacher today, okay? So you're gonna stand right there and we're gonna stand back here like your students.
Okay. Ready?
Yes.
Hands up. Down. Twist. Twist your feet. And twist your head.
Oh, deadly.
And then twist your hands. And then step back.
Okay, so bring it on, Ashley Banjo. You're going down, okay? 5, 6, 7, 8. It seemed like you had an awesome time with Ashley, okay? He also had an awesome time. Check out the video message.
Niamh, it was great having you in London and great having you over in the Diversity Studios. We were really impressed and really humbled by your talent. And let me tell you now, if we were ever to have a female member in Diversity, we'd pick you first. So remember, dream, believe, achieve, and keep dancing.
Whoa! Before you leave, okay, we have diversity goodies to give to you.
Diversity goodies?
Jared Street Factory badge! Our next dreamer is 13-year-old David O'Callaghan. For as long as he can remember, he has been mad about horses. He said, my dream is to be a jump jockey and I want to win the top races like the Grand National or the Cheltenham Gold Cup. Well, saddle up, David, and get ready for the main event.
My name is David O'Callaghan. I'm 13 years old and I've been riding a horse since I was 5. The horses are just so gentle and nice and I just love them. And I love riding and jumping.
What's up? We're making your dream come true today.
I got a video message off Jedward. I was really excited.
My dream came true?
I'm really looking forward to hanging out with Barry Geraghty for today and learning what it takes to be a great jockey.
Hey David, how are you?
Good, how are you, Barry?
Good, yeah, very good, thanks.
He's one of the best jockeys around.
Met David this morning, my parents' yard, Pelletstown.
Let's go.
And started off by mucking out a few horses. This is the fella we're going to muck out.
Nice, what's his name?
His name is Cheve.
We went off to muck out stables, but I did it instead of him. How do you feel at the start of like a big race, like the Grand National?
You don't want to be getting too nervous, you want to be just concentrating on what you're meant to be doing.
Keep calm.
Keep calm, exactly. This is a 4-year-old called Nicholas Chauvin.
He watched me grooming the horses.
You've been riding since you're 5. Are you jumping a little bit? And
yeah, do a bit of jump, about that high jump.
You jump that high, good man.
And Sam stood there with his gear, his boots and his back protector, and he looked confident and he looked like he knew what he was going at.
Oh, good man.
He knew what he was doing when he got up on a horse, so he rode very well.
Right, David, you fancy popping a pole?
Yeah.
Good man, okay. Around you go. Around the cone and back up. Just keep him in a trot. Good lad, well done.
I was in front of Barry Geraghty, a great jockey, so I wanted to please him.
Good man, ride him on. Well done.
I got more comfortable as I jumped more and more.
Yo, big one. Up here, we'll walk across this bank here.
So we walked up bigger then, and we said we'd chance the double bank.
How would you feel about jumping off that? You fancy it?
Yeah, it does. That was about 5 foot off the ground. It was quite steep on the way up.
You want to sit tight now?
Yeah. First time I did it, I nearly fell off, and it was a bit shaky after that. Then he got me back into it, and I got more confident.
Think of your weight in your heel.
Yeah.
Keep your foot close to the girth, because that's your balance point.
Yeah. Next few times, it was great. No slips, no trips, nothing.
Now you are doing it. Good lad, well done.
It was the first time jumping a bank like that, so did well, in fairness.
Well done. Good man.
We got down for a little break.
These are my mother's silks, so you better be careful and mind them.
I was honoured to wear them, because it's Barry Geraghty's family.
So we'd leave them two lads there sunbathing.
Yep.
We'll go for a cup of tea.
He's a great jockey, and he's just had a fantastic career, and his pictures to remember everything.
That was Moscow Flair. I was doing a Frankie Dettori jump off him.
Did it hurt when you landed there?
No, it landed on my feet that day. I think I slipped on my bum once or twice, but it landed on my feet that day.
We went out to the gallops, trotted around the first few times, so I got used to it.
OK, David, you ready to do a little canter?
Yeah. The first lap wasn't as fast as I thought it would be. He taught me how to stand up.
So when you're riding a racehorse, David, you want to get your weight off the back. So you want to get up like that. Can you stand up like that?
Yeah.
Looks good. We'll have a go at that.
The second time I went downhill, he went flying off. I got a bit worried, like, is he galloping off now? Am I going to stop him? Then as we got up the hill, I felt more confident.
You all right?
Yeah.
Good lad.
He went around there a few laps, up on his irons, jockey style, and was well able to keep up, and he wasn't afraid of any challenge. He seemed plenty of guts and confidence, so he's definitely got the right sort of attitude.
Brilliant.
Good, good lad. You can make a jockey yet.
I was just thinking, I'm on the gallops for Barry Geraghty here. I'm not going to wish this moment away, because it was the best time of my life.
Why are you so interested in wanting to be a jockey?
It's just something I've been doing since I was younger, and I've loved it ever since. So.
And do you do horse riding lessons?
Yeah, during the summer and holidays.
And who's your favourite jockey?
Barry.
What's the atmosphere like at Grand National? Everybody's betting on the horses, and there's like so much pressure like to win.
I've ridden in probably 12 Grand Nationals, so I'd say my first ones I was nervous, but now I try and enjoy it.
Do you think David has a lot of potential?
Yeah, he rode brilliantly. We got on great. We were there for a day. He jumped, he went around the gallops, he even mucked out a little bit, swept the yard, he worked hard.
Was there any unicorns?
No.
Do unicorns actually exist?
I think they do.
You think so, Barry?
I've never ridden one now, but I think they do, yeah.
Have you ever seen a horse that's like, just out of nowhere, has a crazy bump in the front of its head, and you're like, that's a unicorn?
No, I haven't seen one.
You haven't
only,
seen one?
Only in cartoons.
What? I know. All right, David, OK, we've got something really, really special to give you, OK? Editor, do you know what it is? Barry signed them for you. Why are these gloves so special?
I wore them on Riverside Theatre when he won in Cheltenham this March.
And what else do you need? An OMG Chairs Jean Fratchy badge! Here you go. Thank you. We want you to keep the horse out on the court, and maybe someday you could be a jockey and win the Grand National.
Coming up after the break, we give One Dreamer a luminous behind-the-scenes access to one of our cool new video shoots. Plus, One Dreamer gets a taste for how crisps are made.
Awesome! Love music videos, and I love to see how they're made. Well, Orla, get ready to shout, lights, camera, action!
I got a letter, and it told me that my dream was going to come true.
We heard you love making your own videos, and that your dream was to go behind the scenes of a music video. Well, guess what? We want to make your dream come true.
Oh my God! Don't cry!
I'm just so excited. And it's just amazing. I just like love making videos. We came to Ardmore Studios in Bray, went around the corner and the shutters started opening and John and Edward were there.
What's going on? It's John and Edward, our luminous video shoot. Oh my God, what's going on?
Yeah. Hey.
Okay, so right now we're here on set shooting our brand new music video for Luminous. The word Jedward, and now in this music video we're Jedi. You and I don't care when the day is gone. all the big producers now around the world are going to see and go, oh my God, John and Eddard need to be in the next Star Wars movie. I could be Anakin. It's like the clipboard. Like nowadays, you
don't they don't use like the old school clipboards. They actually use the one on the iPad.
Here's behind the scenes where wardrobe and makeup is.
John's going to be doing one scene. I'm going to be a nurse scene. So while John's filming, I'm getting ready. So right now, John's doing a scene on his own. The ice scene. It's going to be the new hairstyle.
That's pretty cool.
As you can see, John's getting ready for the next scene. He's trying to get in the zone. He's actually going to be like an Eskimo in the next scene.
He's not an Eskimo, a warrior.
He's a warrior.
We're talking to the choreographer and he showed me like some of the moves.
Now I want you to roll your shoulder.
Come on, follow me, Orla.
There you go.
There was so much stuff that had to happen and like you had to take it so many times.
3, 2, 1, action.
All the background and stuff on the green screen would turn out like a forest and stuff like that.
Okay, let's go for a take.
I can't wait to see what way like it turns out at the end because I've seen only some of it.
You have a good time on set.
It was amazing.
Well, in three, can we all go, that's a wrap? 3, 2, 1, that's a wrap! Seriously, think how cool it was, okay? You were on set for our music video. You're the very, very first fan that's ever, ever been on our music video set. How did that feel?
It was incredible.
Orla, okay? When the shutters came up, like, how did you feel? Like, what were you like?
Oh my God, I was so shocked. Like, I was just, oh my God.
Did you think that was gonna be like, did you think we were like Star Wars?
I didn't know who it was gonna be, because like, you were wearing them boots. It's like, it's not like your normal clothes, like, so it was like, I'm okay, who's this?
That was actually the first time that me and John have ever worn trousers that weren't skinny.
Baggy trousers.
Yeah.
Do you remember I was on the set and I was doing
you're
the
like,
thing?
You like, get bang in the ground.
I know.
Like, I'll show you, I don't know how to do, okay? Oh no! What happened?
I think I ripped the inside of my pants.
Did you hear that? A massive rip went down there. You can't see it right now. Whatever, John, before we go, okay, we want to give you a cool Clippy board theme a jigger. Because
oh my God.
Before she goes and you become like a famous movie director or something like that, we gotta give you an OMG belt! And while other people dream of sheep and their favorite pop star, Kiva dreams of potatoes. She said, my dream is to see how a potato becomes a crisp. How do they slice the potatoes so thinly? And how do they get the flavors on them? So many questions, but so little time. Time to get your crispy, crackling dream underway.
My mom came with a packet of crisps and she told me to open it.
What's that?
I want you to know how crisps are made. Well, guess what? You're going to make your dream come true.
Scream OMG.
OMG!
It was a nice shock. I love crisps because they have loads of different flavours and they're very crispy and they taste nice. This morning, I met Tom, Derek and Ross.
Derek's going to take you to the farm, which is the first step. We need to harvest some potatoes.
How long does it take to grow the potatoes?
Normally it takes about 3 to 4 months.
What time of year do you have to plant them?
Late March and early April. This looks like a good place to dig a few potatoes. Do you want to grab them there like that? Yeah.
Okay, now let's lift them all up.
The potatoes were all covered in mud and they were messy.
This variety is called Lady Clare. These ones are specially planted to make crisps because they give an extra crunchy taste. Looks like we've got enough potatoes there to make a couple of bags of crisps for you.
Okay, thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye-bye. I got my potatoes and I brought them to Ross, who's the chief slicer. He was hand-slicing potatoes. Hi, Ross. Derek told me you're the man to help me cut up all these spuds.
I thought I was just finished all my spuds for the year. This is my last ones. I'm only joking. We don't do it this way anymore. We have machines that do it for us now. This machine here gets your potatoes and takes all the clay, dirt and potatoes that are too small out of them. That's your potatoes there that you picked this morning. The next time I'll see them, they'll be coming out the other side of the washer, all washed and polished. We'll head on to the inspection now and make sure that only the best potatoes are going to go into your crisps.
We look for a blemish, a cut, maybe a bit of a rot. There'll be a bad one here. We'll throw that one out. Want to throw that in here? Yeah.
There was a lot of potatoes, but I didn't mind. We brought the potatoes in to get sliced and cooked.
Ross, you ready? Ready. Okay, I'm going to get you a sample of slice.
And the potatoes came flying out of the slicer into the hot oil.
How do you know when they're cooked?
The crisps are cooked when steam stops coming out of the potato.
It was really exciting to see a potato that I picked in the morning turning into a crisp.
You can see the crisps are starting to bubble and they're starting to get a little bit more golden. So slowly but surely they're starting to cook. What do you think?
It's nearly ready.
I'm happy with them too. We're going to send these crisps to the inspection line. We have a look at the crisps and we make sure everything's 100%.
I measured the crisps to make sure they were the right size, and if they weren't, I just ate them. There was quite a lot of crisps that weren't the right size.
Okay, Quiva, you can see the flavour being added to the crisps and mixed in the drum. Mm-hmm. And this is where we weigh them into their small little bags. Mm-hmm. You've been a great help today. So much so that we put your name on the back of every bag. Look, cooked by Quiva. This is our top secret flavour lab. Now, not a lot of people get to see in here.
We made a flavour for Jedward.
They like some really crazy foods.
Yeah, really crazy.
We have to do this in secrecy, so I think we need to get rid of all these cameras. Do you think we have it?
Yeah, I think we did it.
Let's go put this into production.
Just to make this clear, this is not the crisp factory, this is the dream factory, okay?
Do you see crisps around here?
Oh, wait, there's some on the table.
I brought some flavours for you and you need to guess which ones they are.
We taste them? Let's taste them, John. Here, let's taste the first one. This is A. I know what tastes like. It tastes like Chinese. Chow mein. It tastes like chicken. Celery?
No.
What flavour is it?
It's sushi and cereal.
I can taste it now. Good job, okay? Let's move on to B. It tastes like pizza. What flavour is it?
Shamrock and sour cream.
We're eating shamrocks?
Yeah.
So if we eat loads of this, we're going to, like, become ultra lucky?
Yeah.
If we eat more of these, we're going to become leprechauns? You did an amazing job. We've got a huge, huge surprise. It's a huge bag of crisps. Oh, my God! That you can eat at home. This is like a lifetime supply. You will never have to buy a bag of crisps for the rest of your life. But we also have an OMG badge! Edward, we made some great dreams come true today. I couldn't possibly pick a favorite. I know, John, they've all been amazing, but until next time, until we open the doors of the Dream Factory, keep dreaming!
Time in the Dream Factory. Young marine biologist has dream encounters with sharks and these cute seal pups. Aww. The Dream Factory goes snooker loopy as Irish world champ Ken Doherty makes a dream come true. Rugby star Jamie Heaslip drops in his pampered pooch with Ireland's newest celebrity dog groomers. And dreams come true in the Dream Factory audience as John serenades one of our crazy fans.